Next on PIJN News, Dr. Chaps reports on these important issues.
Modern horror movies show the occult and counterfeit spirituality. But is it time for a Christian movie that shows real spirituality? We interview Bill Myers, producer of the new Christian horror movie, Forbidden Doors.
Former Navy Chaplain Gordon James Klingenschmitt took a stand to defend religious freedom by daring to pray publicly in Jesus' name. Now he helps you by reporting the news, discerning the spirits, and praying the scriptures. Would you pray with us? Here's Dr. Chaps.
God bless you in Jesus' name. My name is Chaplain Gordon James Klingenschmitt, Dr. Chaps, and you're watching PIJN News. Today we're going to have a live Skype interview with Bill Myers, who is a Christian movie producer of this new project called Forbidden Doors, based on a children's book series. Now, we've all seen cheesy Christian films where the priest tries to cast out demons with a holy water and crucifix. And, of course, the demons end up winning and everybody else loses. Or we've seen how many lame, preachy movies where the pastor regurgitates scripture with a desperate churchgoer who's just looking for truth. But there's a different kind of movie that is going to be appealing to teenagers, and it's based on scripture. In this plot in Forbidden Doors, the movie, it deals with two teens who return to California from an Amazon mission field only to discover that the entire town is caught up in occult activity. Maybe that's a little more closer to the truth than we realize. Let's take a short look at a clip with Bill Myers, and then when we come back from the commercial, we'll have him live for the interview.
Situations or Brady Bunch characters. This is today. Element. Every day, darkness seems to grow around us. Elements of the occult are everywhere. In fact, today, among American teenagers, pagan rituals are growing faster than mainstream religion. And what does the media do? It glorifies it, often making it look like a game. But what if there was a motion picture that showed the real truth? What if there was a film that showed the power of Jesus Christ and the weapons his followers could use to bring down that darkness? Welcome to Forbidden Doors, a movie based upon the 12-part book series that won the C.S. Lewis Honor Award. Now, this is no namby-pammy Christian film, you know, with cheesy situations or Brady Bunch characters. This is today, and though it's fiction, a sizable part of it's based upon reality. I mean, I've done my homework. I've interviewed the head of the CIA Psychic Research Division, the son of Sam's serial killer, and demoniacs and psychics and you name it. And the reason was I wanted it to be authentic. I wanted to accurately capture the real power that real believers have.
For decades, the studios and networks have controlled what we watch, often making Christians look weak and mindless. In horror films, for example, they have us putting all our faith in crucifixes, holy water, and chunks of garlic.
So what are we supposed to do? You know, instead of ignoring the problem, we've decided to turn the tables in a powerful motion picture and unmask the occult for what it really is. And more importantly, to proclaim the power of Jesus Christ to overcome it. And that's why I want to welcome you to join us in raising funds for Forbidden Doors movie.
Now picture it. A couple of American teenagers move back to California from the rainforest where they've been serving, only to discover that their classmates, in fact the entire town, are playing with the very forces of darkness they've been told to avoid at any cost. So now this reluctant brother and sister team must use every weapon in the believer's arsenal to destroy that darkness and to set the captives free. Are there thrills and chills in the storytelling? Boy, I hope so. But more importantly, we get to see the awesome power of Jesus Christ. And that's a story worth telling.
We're really excited to be part of the distribution team for the Forbidden Doors movies. Our executives have got more than 50 years of combined experience in international distribution, so we understand how to put a picture out both overseas and at home.
We have the major funding in place. All we need is for you to come alongside us to raise the final $400,000. Or more, because the bigger the budget, the better the film. And not just that, but we have even bigger plans.
After seeing a film like Forbidden Doors, we're expecting there to be some curiosity, some questions. So as a means to provide answers to those questions, in addition to the film, we'll be creating a web platform. Basically, anyone looking to dive more deeply into the subject matter, particularly Jesus Christ, this will be your resource.
To the right of your screen, you'll see the various incentives and rewards for helping us. Anything from t-shirts to DVDs, signed scripts, or to even being an extra or having a speaking role in the film.
But above all, you'll be joining with us to finally tell the whole world the whole truth about the power of Jesus Christ. Thanks.
Discerning the spirits that rule our politicians, Dr. Chaps will be right back.
Do you care about defending religious liberty? I know you do. And that's why I'm asking you to take action today. Don't just sit there, but do something. Visit our website, PrayInJesusName.org, and sign a petition that we will fax to Congress on your behalf. In fact, there are three specific petitions I want you to sign to defend military chaplains who are under fire. The first is to support H.R. 343. This is a bill introduced in Congress by my friend, Congressman Walter Jones of North Carolina, to protect free speech for military chaplains who are sometimes punished if they use the word Jesus in their prayers. Well, if you know my story, you know that I was punished in 2006, even at court-martial, because I used the word Jesus in my prayers in uniform in front of the White House. Well, I was later vindicated by Congress, who said it's okay for me to do that, but did you know 65 other chaplains are now suing the Navy? I was not the only person. Our second petition I want you to sign is to protect military chapel buildings, which are being desecrated. Christian altars, Catholic or Protestant, are being desecrated by homosexual wedding ceremonies in all 50 states under this order by the Obama administration. Well, that deprives all of our soldiers, sailors, airmen, and Marines of a sacred worship space, which ought to be protected. And instead, they're going to punish the chaplain if he won't turn over the keys to his chapel. Here's another petition I want you to sign, and this is to stop threatening court-martial for troops who talk about Jesus. Even recently, the Pentagon is saying, oh, we're going to threaten you with a crime of proselytizing. No, that's not right. Any soldier ought to be able to talk about his or her faith in Jesus Christ and to have that same religious freedom of speech that we sacrifice to give for others. When you sign these petitions, we will fax them to Congress, and it's free. I want you to take action today. Sign these three important petitions at PrayInJesusName.org. Go there today.
Defending your religious freedom, here is Dr. Chaps.
Welcome back. Thank you for watching PIJN News. We're joined now via Skype from California by my new friend, Bill Myers, president of Ameris Media International, and you are a movie producer. Welcome, Bill Myers.
Thanks. It's good to be here.
So you're producing this new idea, this script. It's based on a successful Christian book series that you wrote, published by Tyndale House, Forbidden Doors. Can you talk about the concept and the characters, and how did you get interested in this?
Oh, sure. After I was writing a lot of children's projects, still am. And after the success of McGee and Me, which I created, Tyndale Publishers called up and said, would you write a Christian horror series? I said, no, I'm kind of busy with my Christian pornography series right now. What are you talking about?
Of course, you're joking. Christian horror is like an oxymoron, right?
Yeah, absolutely. And they said, okay, Mr. Sarcasm, you go to the secular bookstores and you look at what's out there. And I did the research. And at that time, there were about, I'd say, 70% of the bookshelf space was dedicated to the paranormal, to the occult, to the supernatural. So I went back to Tyndale and I said, I'll write your series, but you let me use it as an educational series. So I promise you, the kids will still want to turn pages, and it'll be, you know, have all the things that go bump in the night, but it'll show the power of Jesus Christ, and it will expose the various supernatural counterfeits that are seducing today's teens. And so we had an agreement, and I wrote a 12-part book series that won the C.S. Lewis Honor Award a while back. And that was fine, and the series is puttering along just great. But not as many kids read books as watch movies.
Right.
So
So the movie plot, or at least the summary that I see here, it deals with two teenagers who return to California from the Amazon mission field, only to discover that their classmates, in fact, the entire town, is caught up in occult activity. And so the teenagers do what? They try to evangelize the town?
Well, first of all, they try to figure out what is occult and what isn't. They start to uncover the power of scripture and the power of worship. So they explore the various things that the people are involved with. They see how those things are poisonous to the soul. And then they go to scripture and they start to learn the authority they have in Christ to free their friends of those things. So yes, the town eventually gets freed. Their friends get freed. But the kids, the brother and sister, are learning the supernatural warfare tools mentioned in scripture as they go along in the story.
So it's kind of like a reverse zombie movie. Instead of, you know, one person becomes a zombie and eventually the entire town is a zombie, this is like two people are Christians and eventually the entire town gets free of their demonic activity.
Well, at least in the first movie, their friends do. Yeah. And it's not your everyday kind of family Christian film. There are things that, you know, that keep you wanting to watch. There's no gore or anything like that, but there is definitely supernatural encounters that the kids learn they can overcome through the name of Jesus Christ. But it doesn't happen overnight, because that's what a story is, as they learn. Hopefully there's no cheesy dialogue or Brady Bunch type of characters like we talked about, so that it's real. And it's based on real situations, but we've amped everything up a bit just so that the teen will continue to watch.
So the book series is already very successful among teens, not just Christian teens, but it has a Christian theme. So you're using this to reach into the culture. What have parents told you, or maybe some teens who have read your books?
I get email on a regular basis from both parents and teens. Some of them are just whacked out, but there's a certain core of kids that are involved in this sort of stuff, and they're writing their thanks for helping them get out. I don't know if you know, but Wicca is the fastest growing religion amongst American teens today.
Wicca, so like witchcraft because of the Harry Potter series, maybe?
Well, that would certainly be my call, yeah. It's just that slippery slope as we go darker and darker and darker. In fact, last year when I went to the secular bookstore in my town, 15 shelves were dedicated to teen paranormal romance. And we're talking about teenage girls having relationships with supernatural creatures. And that was pretty disturbing. So we're reaching into that culture. Yes, certainly we would want Christians to see it, but we're also reaching out to a world that vaguely knows who Jesus Christ is.
So you're trying to combat all that darkness with a good story about Jesus that provides a little bit of light into the culture.
Precisely. Yep.
So talk about the movie script, or you're in the process of fundraising and developing, and what is the process to make this into a movie?
Well, the process is to find a good story, to work on the script, to make sure the script is not cornball, make sure that it's relevant, and we have readers and people to participate with that. And then we just go out and look for investors. Sometimes, like this Kickstarter program that we talked about, we'd like it to be a community of people donating as little as $5. In other cases, with some of other children's projects, we're looking for investors that see the necessity of reaching children with the gospel before they become adults.
Well, and you've already had a lot of success reaching children. Like you said, you created the McGee and Me series with Focus on the Family, very successful video series. You also did some other film projects. But where can people go? And I don't want to, you know, we're going to take a break here and we'll talk more about this after the break, but initially, where can people go if they want to pledge $5 to help you get this off the ground?
That would best be going to the ForbiddenDoorsMovie.com.
ForbiddenDoorsMovie.com. We're going to take a short break. When we come back, more with Bill Myers, a movie producer from California. We'll be right back.
Making your voice heard in our nation's capital. Dr. Chaps will be right back.
Do you care about defending religious liberty? I know you do. And that's why I'm asking you to take action today. Don't just sit there, but do something. Visit our website, PrayInJesusName.org, and sign a petition that we'll fax to Congress on your behalf. In fact, there are three specific petitions I want you to sign to defend military chaplains who are under fire. The first is to support H.R. 343. This is a bill introduced in Congress by my friend, Congressman Walter Jones of North Carolina, to protect free speech for military chaplains who are sometimes punished if they use the word Jesus in their prayers. Well, if you know my story, you know that I was punished in 2006, even at court-martial, because I used the word Jesus in my prayers in uniform in front of the White House. Well, I was later vindicated by Congress, who said it's okay for me to do that. But did you know 65 other chaplains are now suing the Navy? I was not the only person. Our second petition I want you to sign is to protect military chapel buildings, which are being desecrated. Christian altars, Catholic or Protestant, are being desecrated by homosexual wedding ceremonies in all 50 states under this order by the Obama administration. Well, that deprives all of our soldiers, sailors, airmen, and Marines of a sacred worship space, which ought to be protected. And instead, they're going to punish the chaplain if he won't turn over the keys to his chapel. Here's another petition I want you to sign, and this is to stop threatening court-martial for troops who talk about Jesus. Even recently, the Pentagon is saying, oh, we're going to threaten you with a crime of proselytizing. No, that's not right. Any soldier ought to be able to talk about his or her faith in Jesus Christ and to have that same religious freedom of speech that we sacrifice to give for others. When you sign these petitions, we will fax them to Congress, and it's free. I want you to take action today. Sign these three important petitions at PrayInJesusName.org. Go there today. Welcome back. Thank you again for watching PIJN News. I'm joined again by my new friend, Bill Myers, a Christian movie producer from California via Skype. Welcome back, Bill.
Hi. Well, hi.
So Bill, we were talking about your history working with Focus on the Family, and you've produced the McGee and Me video series in the 90s. That was very popular. You also worked on The Incredible Worlds of Wally McDougal, yes. And you've had a history. How did you get into film in the first place? You like to write and tell stories.
Well, I was going to be a dentist, and I, at 18 years old, promised the Lord I would always say yes to him. Always, regardless of how it may not make sense. And my freshman year in college, I went to see the fourth movie of my life. I had seen Pollyanna, I had seen The Parent Trap, and I'd seen Pinocchio. And now I'm sitting in a movie theater watching The Godfather. And people at the end of the movie were standing up and cheering when people were getting massacred on the screen. And I just walked out of that theater telling the Lord to pay attention. There's power in the movies. Didn't he know that? Maybe he should raise people up and get them involved in this industry. And every time I told the Lord what he had to do, it sort of bounced back at me that I was supposed to be one of those guys. So I changed my major, started studying filmmaking, didn't even know how to watch a movie, let alone make one. But over the years now, and that was about 35 years ago, hopefully I've learned my craft and we're starting to make an impact on our culture.
Well, and you are a storyteller. This new movie that you want to make, Forbidden Doors, is based on a 12-book series, Forbidden Doors, but you've written how many other books?
I've written 123, working on 124 now, yeah.
That's amazing. I mean, look at the bookshelf behind you. I think you're starting to compete with those 15 rows of, occult books that are geared toward teenagers. So thank you for impacting children. Why do you gear your books toward children?
Because children listen. Because children are still malleable. They're still tender. Most of it's interesting with McGee and Me. To this day, I get email from now college students or even parents that say that series changed my life. Now I've written some grown-up stuff, and we're pursuing that as films as well. But the ones that I hold the dearest are these letters that say, my life was totally refocused as a result of watching most often your children's projects. So I think telling story is okay. It's a nice job, but changing lives, nothing beats that.
You know, as a chaplain and as an evangelist, I want to win the world for Jesus Christ. And I've read a study that like 90% of everybody who becomes a Christian will do so before they turn 18. So yes. Do you think our investing strategy as a missionary church should be geared toward children? And how are you helping to do that? And why don't people invest more in that?
It's a good question. I think I can't speak for the church in general, but I can speak about the Christian movie ministries. It's very, very, very difficult for us to find investors that are interested in investing in children's projects. This baffles me. It leaves me totally confused because, as you just said, the statistics show that that's when the lives are the most deeply touched. I'm not sure why. Maybe because doing an adult film somehow seems more artistic or more glamorous. But the children are falling left and right. I mean, we're talking about a war for their souls. And as we go out looking for investors, because we have many children's projects that we're gearing up to do, it's almost like their eyes kind of glaze over and they can hardly wait until we talk about a grown-up project. But that's our passion, is to reach the children, because the children are the ones that listen the most and are most affected.
Now talk about Kickstarter. I'm not familiar with this, but you're trying to finance a new Christian movie. It might be coming out in October of 2015, but you want to secure your financing this week. And there's a deadline coming up on Kickstarter. What is that and how does it work?
Well, Kickstarter gives an opportunity for people to across the nation to invest as little as $5 in a project. Now, they don't become film producers or film investors, but we give them gifts and things like that. What it does is it gives an opportunity for the whole body of Christ to work together as a family to produce a project. So this is the only one we're running with Kickstarter right now, because we want to see the interest. If indeed we want to work together as a family. If the money is not raised by the deadline, which I believe is November 16, all of the money goes back to the people that have donated it.
So wait, I could make a pledge of, you know, $100, and it's no risk. If you don't also get the other $399,000, then I get my $100 back.
Exactly. We've you know, we've already have investors that are picking up 60% of the tab, so we're looking for the last 40%. But yeah, if that last 40% is not raised through Kickstarter, all the money returns to the individuals. So it looks like a win-win situation, and we're hoping that the family of Christ will step up and participate with us on it.
Well, thank you. You have my pledge. I'm going to pledge $100 to this. It's no risk. I hope you get your goal and reach your goal. But if you don't, then I get my money back. So, well, you know, it doesn't matter to me, I guess. But I care about children and I care about what you're doing. Bill, how can people contact you and where can they go to make that pledge?
Well, to contact me personally, and I answer every email I get, it's bill@billmyers.com. M-Y-E-R-S, bill@billmyers.com. Now, for the Kickstarter program, it would be best to go to our website, which is forbiddendoorsmovie.com, and then that will direct you where you go. And if you get lost, just email me and I'll direct you to it.
forbiddendoorsmovie.com. Please go there today and make a pledge. The deadline is coming up by November 16th. He needs to have all those pledges in place. You can get involved for as little as $5. Thank you again, my dear friend, Bill Myers, and I welcome you to call us at PIJN News.
Thank you. It's been great being here.
All right. We'll be right back after this short break.
This is PIJN News.
Introducing FaxCongress.com. Do you care about politics, defending pro-life causes, traditional marriage, and religious freedom? At FactsCongress.com, you can create any petition to Congress, and we will convert your e-petition instantly to real fax paper on your congressman's desk. And the best part? It's free. Want your voice heard by multiple congressmen? At FactsCongress.com, we can blast your petition to all 535 congressmen and senators instantly, and you don't even need a fax machine. Not only do we deliver your petitions instantly, but with our dashboard feature, you can quickly recruit friends on Facebook and Twitter to co-sign your petition. Do you care about a particular cause? You can build a virtual army of supporters at FactsCongress.com. Do you lead a church, faith-based organization, or PAC? We can even help you do fundraising. It's free. Just visit FactsCongress.com and try it out. Make a difference. Sign any petition today at FactsCongress.com. FactsCongress.com.
Can I take a moment to ask you to donate today? There are such important battles that we're fighting and winning around the country to defend religious liberty. How much is the right to pray in Jesus' name worth to you? Well, to me, it was worth a 16-year career and a million-dollar pension, which I sacrificed to defend Jesus Christ. I'm asking you to call us today, toll-free at 866-OBEY-GOD, and make a donation. How much would you pay to defend religious liberty? Would you give $10 or $20 or $100? I bet there's some people who are watching who can even give $1,000 today just to help us stay on the air, to broadcast this into people's homes, to organize these petition drives, and especially, we spend thousands of dollars organizing rallies around the country and petitioning legislators. Please call us today at 866-OBEY-GOD and give the best pledge that you can give to defend religious liberty and take a stand for Jesus Christ. We can't do it without you. Please donate today. Our thanks again to Bill Myers for taking that leap. And we encourage you to go to his website, ForbiddenDoorsMovie.com, and support him on Kickstarter. But also please donate to PrayInJesusName.org if you can. The Bible says in Luke 6, give and it will be given to you. God bless you in Jesus' name. We'll see you next time.
Chaplain Klingenschmitt is a graduate of the U.S. Air Force Academy who earned his Ph.D. in theology from Regent University. As a former Navy chaplain, by taking a public stand for freedom of speech and religious expression, and by sacrificing his own 16-year career and million-dollar pension, he was vindicated by the U.S. Congress, who changed the law and restored freedom for military chaplains to pray in Jesus' name. Dr. Chaps not only defended the Constitution, but his petitions have helped change the law in 10 states, restoring freedom to pray in Jesus' name. Dr. Chaps needs your financial support to stay on the air. Would you please send your best donation today? Please visit PrayInJesusName.org to donate online. Or you can mail a check to Pray in Jesus Name Ministries, Post Office Box 77077, Colorado Springs, Colorado 80970. You can also call us toll-free right now at 866-OBEY-GOD. That's 866-OBEY-GOD. Please sign up for our free emails at PrayInJesusName.org. Again, that's PrayInJesusName.org.